Hello mga motorista! Welcome na naman sa isang Motorista Adventures na video. For this episode, andito tayo sa Mitsubishi Bulwa, Cagayan de Oro City mga motorista. No? Today's video will be about the Mitsubishi Triton GLX model 4x2 automatic transmission. So itong review unit natin mga motorista is the red color. No? Again, I really like the red color. I think na-videohan ko na yon in the GLS form in the launch. So ngayon, let's take a look at the GLS model, no? So ano yung mga makikita natin dito sa labas at loob niya. So definitely same as the Triton GLS, no? Napakaganda ng design, macho looking. It's definitely a very fresh looking design, no, from Mitsubishi's lineup, especially with the older generation na Mitsubishi Strada is still being sold, I think, dito sa Cagayan de Oro. I'm not so sure in other parts in the country, but they still have, no, ayan, nasa kabilang ano, mga motorista, yung ating Strada dyan. Definitely, if you want the latest and the greatest offering from Mitsubishi when it comes to the pickup truck, dito ka sa Mitsubishi Triton. So number one dyan mga motorista na pag-usapan natin is the design. No? I really like the design. It is bigger, wider than before, and also very different, no, in look and feel. Now, itong GLS model, since this is the lower grade model, no, it is priced, no, dito sa Cagayan de Oro to, ha. So meron silang dagdag around 60,000 pesos for the freight, no, and handling. So GLX two-wheel drive automatic nila is 1,443,000. Yun yung base SRP nila dito sa Cagayan. Let's talk about the equipment that you get dito sa ating Triton. So all halogens na mga motorista. So no LEDs here. So yan yung i-expect nyo for this, for the price point. So again, halogen headlights, multi-reflector siya. Meron tayong DRLs, but again, it's still a bulb type na DRL, no? Meron tayong bulb type turn signal lights. So if you expect LEDs, you have to go for the GLS model talaga mga motorista, no? And bump up your budget to the GLS. Now moving on to the side of the Triton mga motorista, it is the same as the GLS, yung ating mga rims and the tires itself. So I really like the thickness of it mga motorista, no? Particularly this Triton na nire-review natin, meron siyang ano, meron siyang accessories, no? If you can see that on the video, meron tayong mga ano, fender extenders. So kung gusto mong palaparin yung gulong, so magko-complement 'yan, no, sa ating mga black na fender extender. And meron din tayong fuel cap cover na nasa likuran. So for this GLX, meron siyang step board, a standard, and I almost forgot, meron din tong ano, rain visor mga motorista na kasama sa accessory pack. I think you have to add that on to the price, of course. Moving on to the back of the Triton, same deal sa likod mga motorista, no? Wala tayong LEDs, so lahat halogen, although the design is new. But again, all halogens yung ating mga taillights, brake lights, signal lights, and reverse light. What I like is meron tayong reverse camera, no? Hindi na tinanggalan ng reverse camera for this GLX. The definition of the camera is very good. Not the best, but okay na din siya for the lower grade models. Meron pala tayong ano, bed liner sa likod. Which is again included na, no? So that's quite good. So all around, yung mga handle, yung door handles pala natin is chrome. So mga motorista, yung engine naman ng ating Mitsubishi Triton is a 2.4-liter turbocharged direct injection. It has a maximum output of 183 PS and a maximum torque of 430, and it is Euro 5 na siya mga motorista, no? So meaning it's very clean yung nilalabas din to mga motorista na usok, no? So hindi siya ganun ka-toxic as the lower numbered na Euro versions ng other competitors nito. Okay, so in this case to, we have a 6-speed automatic transmission for this Triton GLX. So moving on to the interior mga motorista, dito talaga maganda si Triton, no? Especially in this GLX model, because it still has a lot of the things that nasa mga higher end nila na mga models like the GLS and also the Athlete model. Okay, so tara, tignan natin yung interior, mga motorista. You have leather-wrapped steering wheel. Very nice. Meron siya mga dimples dito. Alright, very ergonomic na steering wheel. And also, mga motorista, kita nyo din, you have your buttons here to control the screen right up front kasi meron din itong screen. So, hindi na tinanggalan ng screen. Right? So, this is a 7-inch display dito sa harap natin, no? Very much improved in comparison to the Nissan Navara's display, no? So, mas malalaki. Lahat legible, mga motorista. Napaka-easy mong makita yung mga information and details dito. Anyway, you have speedometer, tachometer, malalaki yan lahat yung mga phones natin. Dito naman sa side, you have your switches para sa ating headlight and also our fog light. Dito din, no? So, tilt. And, yeah, telescoping yung ating steering wheel. Now, moving on dito sa ating doors, which I really like kasi leather siya, no? So, kung saan tatama yung mga elbows mo, soft touch leather, meron siyang white stitching. You also have no lock and unlock buttons right here. And then you have folding mirrors. And yung mirrors natin, once ilalock mo siya, mag-auto fold siya. No? You can adjust it on the settings right there. Automatic up and down for the driver, pero manual toggles na for the passengers. But still, power windows pa din siya. No? Meron tayong parang carbon fiber na plastic design here. Leather yung armrest. And disusi pa siya, mga motorista, no? Si Triton, unfortunately, hindi siya engine push to start. If you want engine push to start, dun ka sa GLS model. Moving on to the infotainment system. Infotainment system is quite good as well. It is a 8-inch display. In terms of the quality, it's still very good, but hindi siya ganun ka high definition if you compare it to the GLS model. Yung GLS natin, mas high definition yung display natin, mas crisp yung graphics natin, mga motorista, no? Yung ating display has Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, but hindi siya wireless, mga motorista. Wired pa din siya. What I like dito sa screen is meron kang shortcuts na for dimming, you have next, audio menu, call button, camera button. In this case, settings lang siya kasi hindi siya 360. Kung GLS to, mga motorista, it will show you the 360 camera right then and there. Okay, so meron tayong tuning knob, meron tayong volume knobs right here, meron tayong vents also dito, mga motorista, which is nice looking. Hazard button natin on the center part, and then digital climate control, right? Single zone, hindi siya dual zone unlike the higher models. Dito sa lalim, 12-volt outlet, and what I really like sa mga bagong for this Triton is meron na siyang Type-C port dito sa harap, no? And USB na normal. Pero tignalagyan here, but wala na siyang wireless charging. That's reserved for the high-end models. So, meron din tayong shifter dito na malaki, chunky na chunky. Park, reverse, neutral, and drive. Meron tayong manual mode here. Meron tayong blank switches here. I think this is for the four-wheel drive switches, no? For the 4x4 models. And then, you have your cup holders here. Standard handbrake, hindi siya electronic, not bad. Leather armrest. Meron tayong mga malalaking storage spaces, no? I think this is one of the biggest na upper storage compartment than the competitors. And also dito sa ilalim, very decent naman yung ating storage compartment. Now, when it comes to the safety feature, meron tayong, when it comes to the basic safety feature, meron tayong traction control, stability control dito sa ating base model. You have airbags as well. Unfortunately, 3 airbags lang. Okay, once you get to the top of the lane model, I think those are the 7 airbags na. So, hindi pala 6, no? 7 airbags for the top of the line model. And then here, it's just 3 airbags for the GLX model. Okay, so take note of that, mga motorista. Meron tayong day and night rearview mirror. And dome lights natin is incandescent, no? So, as you can see, yellow yan. Frosted type. No vanity mirror. Meron tayong vanity mirror. You have headlight adjuster dito, which is nice to have. And then you can adjust the brightness ating display using these toggles dito sa ilalim. Okay, so by the way, also meron tayong 6 speaker system. So I think I've covered everything, mga motorista, dito sa ating Triton sa harap. Now let's move on to the back. Let's take a look at how comfortable it is sa second row. And tignan natin yung space. Okay, so dito sa likod ng ating Mitsubishi Triton, as you can see, mga motorista, no, big improvement when it comes to space, no. Yung mga seats natin dito sa harap is medyo malapad na siya. Meron tayong grab handles dito, dito din, no, grab handles. So hindi siya yung nagpo-fold, permanent siya na kaganyan. You get seat belts, no, for sa likod, of course. And leather din yung armrest dito. One of the things that I'm missing dito sa likod is rear aircon vents, no, which is not here. And then meron tayong 12-volt outlet. So one of the things that I really like sa mga Triton is they incorporated Type-C ports na dito sa likuran, no. So that's easier, no, for you to charge your iPhone. You don't need to buy another cable, no. Meron namang type A, pero again, it's better, no, kapag type C na siya para mas compatible sa lahat ng mga gadgets nowadays. So meron tayong tunnel dito sa ilalim, maliit lang naman siya, hindi siya ganun ka intrusive. Meron tayong armrest with cup holders dito sa likuran, and the seats dito sa likod is quite comfortable. Okay, so napaka-comfortable dito sa likod. So I am 5'7 in height. So as you can see, a lot of headroom. Yung seat natin malambot, no? And then pati yung inuupuan ko, good thigh support as well. So mga motorista, if naghahanap kayo ng Triton in Cagayan de Oro City, no, meron tayong dealer dito sa Cagayan, which is Fast Auto World. They are located in Bulwa, Cagayan de Oro City. They would be more than happy to help you, no, in choosing the right vehicle for you dito sa Mitsubishi Cagayan de Oro. So meron silang maraming displays dito sa kanilang showroom. So if you can drop by here, no, they have staff and sales executive to help you with your purchase decision. So ayan mga motorista, maraming salamat for watching this video. As always, hit the like button, subscribe, click that notification bell for more videos in this channel. Meron tayong Facebook page and meron din tayong YouTube channel, which is you will be watching it, yung video natin for this episode. Maraming salamat mga motorista, and I'll see you on the next episode. Bye-bye.